Breaking up with your broker or advisor can be awkward, which is why many clients choose to stay against their better judgment. But what if the relationship is costing you millions of dollars? When Mark Hebner sold his business for a large sum in 1985, he hired a broker to advise him on how to invest the proceeds. He thought little more about it for the next 12 years or so, but then he started learning how to invest himself. To his amazement and annoyance, Mark discovered that if he'd simply invested the money in low-cost index funds, he'd be about $30 million better off. Shocking though it might seem, it is in fact the norm for active investors to underperform the broader market. Both academic research and industry data show us that only a very small proportion of actively managed funds outperform in the long run on a properly cost and risk-adjusted basis. Mark was prompted to research the subject when a friend's widow asked him for investment advice. It proved to be a real eye-opener.
So I go to Barnes & Noble's and I come out of there with 22 books and I take them home and I start plowing through them. And there were many of the early books written about indexing or passive investing, whatever you want to call it. And there were some other books in there about actively managing your portfolio as well. But one of the things that caught my attention early on was the fact that all the passive investing had this academic evidence associated with it. There were academics telling you this. And in fact, they were Nobel Prize winners. Okay. And I'm going, wait a minute, that carries so much more weight than, you know, something I read in Fortune magazine or the Wall Street Journal to have a peer-reviewed academic paper. This is like totally different than reading somebody's, you know, gut reaction to, you know, what Cisco or Apple or somebody's going to do, you know, or some firm is going to do tomorrow in the stock market. And that was definitely an epiphany for me.
So what does Mark Hebner think now about the advice his broker gave him?
It's funny. I don't really hold this against them. I'm not saying that he's a bad person, but he was in a system and a business model that required him to do that. So he could make an income, and so the firm could make an income. This industry, 99% of it, is designed to get people to trade. It's a commission transactional business, and there's a long list of people who are just waiting for that salesperson to initiate the trade so everybody can take a little piece of that trade. And that's what this industry is all about. The big gambling casino. It's the largest casino, really, in the world.
Like many clients do, Mark had become quite attached to his broker, but he realized they had to go their separate ways.
I wrote a 20-page letter with charts and graphs to this guy because I felt so bad we were breaking up, you know? Breaking up is hard to do, even in the brokerage industry. And so I wrote him this long letter and said, I'm sorry, I'm moving my money to a passive investment kind of strategy, and I really don't need you anymore. So first moved my own money, and then I got the idea of starting my own firm.
That is how IFA.com came into existence. Today, the company manages billions of dollars for clients across the United States, all of it in passively managed portfolios. If your current broker recommends actively managed funds, why not get in touch with us and discover for yourself the benefits of switching to a passive strategy with an independent fiduciary advisor? Contact us via the details top right on the IFA website. Alternatively, click on Connect with an Advisor and enter your email, phone number, and home state. And we'll get back in touch with you.